guys, so I am going in with 30 volume developer and the Kaleida colors from Clairol's blue bleaching powder. So this bleaching powder works very good if you're trying to get dimensions in your dark hair. So this definitely gives you highlights and low lights, which I like. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do kind of like random highlights. I'm going to obviously do ombre all the way at the bottom, and I'm gonna come up and do highlights and stuff just in the top areas. I am gonna do a little bit of a prominent little highlight area in the front, just so that if I split in the middle part, I have two separate little highlight pieces. And even if I do a side part, obviously you guys saw the thumbnail, the color came out beautifully done. Even with the curl formation and everything, it just was so pretty, so nice. So I'm just gonna keep doing this until I get it to a nice even type of tone. I left this hair on the hair for about like 20 to 30 minutes and the color came out nice. Then I just did a deep condition, and then I waited the day after and installed the wig. So everything came out pretty nice. I think the color is very gorgeous and very light and spring to summer type of vibes. So it's definitely something that's very easy. It's not expensive. I bought the hair the bleaching powder for $3 one pack, and the developer was $2. So it was like a $5 purchase and a $5 customization that came out to rip. This unit for about a day, I noticed that I just did not like it in the middle part style. Obviously, if you guys saw the middle part style, the highlights were a little bit wonky, so I decided to go ahead and do a side part style, which is always my favorite style. But don't get me wrong, I love myself a good middle part. So I decided to go ahead and put this middle side part style, which you can see now that the highlights look very realistic, very natural through. So I'm definitely gonna have to wear in the side part style if I want the highlights to pop. So obviously I am cutting it. I told you guys, if it's not gonna give me density, the density, right density for a straight wig, I'm gonna cut it and style it the hell on up. So obviously you guys saw in the beginning the hair was curled, styled, and pretty. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna just throw a little bit of layers in it, just make it look nice and buff. I'm not gonna go super duper short like bob length, but I'm gonna give myself a shoulder length type of cut. And look at the highlights, guys. Look at how freaking amazing this looks. Faulty matter that in the middle part style doesn't look like this, but straight style, you can't tell me nothing on the side part because it looks damn near good. Guys, as usual, I need to go in and do like a little bit of a curled hairstyle look. So because his hair is a weird kind of length, I did go in and just do a light curl. So with this one, the hair is about 14 inch, and I feel like it just looks so much better, so much buff with the curl in it. This curling iron I'm using is from Hot Tools. I got it about like 7 years ago. I'm not sure the barrel or anything like that, but I'm just gonna do a nice curl set to give myself a little bit of bang, since I did cut layers into the front, and just give me like a nice kind of like meltdown kind of slick back look. I love this with my units that are bleached in the front that have a really, really melted laydown. This gives you the ultimate appearance of natural, like, hairline, seriously. So I do want to apologize in advance because it is a little bit loud at my house. So I'm going to try to record this part as fast as possible. So guys, this is the finished look of this unit. So this is a start to finish. So with this unit, I did do a custom colorization and I also did a cut on this. So I wanted to do something for the springtime, summertime. So I wanted to come in with some highlights, type of balayage look. So I'm not professional when it comes to coloring hair, but I think coming off on this one, I think I did a pretty good job. So you guys can see a lot of dimensions of the highlight brown. I did emphasize a lot of it in the front, so even if you split this in the middle part, which you guys did see previous, which I had on 3 days, I've had this wig on for 3 days, so 2 days ago I had it in the middle part style, and I did like the middle part style, but I kind of felt like the middle part style wasn't as oomph enough for me. So you guys know that the hair density, if it's going to be a straight texture and it's not 200 plus or it's not a real thick density, I'm not going to deal with the length and I'm not going to deal with the density, so I'm just going to go ahead and cut it. For me, when I cut the hair about shoulder length like this, it definitely gives me 100% amplified look. Honestly and truly, with the curled style like this and the highlighted colors going through the hair, listen to people, this is official AF. Now, I'm actually thinking about doing more units like this. I was afraid to do highlights and stuff like that in balayage because I felt like sometimes with some hair companies, the hair won't take the bleach well. I did use a blue type of, I've listed up here if I forgot. I honestly forgot. That hair, that bleaching powder is a type of bleaching powder that kind of pulls highlights and lowlights. So this color isn't like a dramatic color of a ombre or balayage. It's like the perfect tone for like a woman of color or anybody that's going for like a slight ombre. I did do all the ends and then I did kind of like some parts where I did like highlighted effects on it, so it's not overall like a completed look, balayage look or ombre look. So I did do like peaks in the front right here and some on the sides and things like that. So I hope it came out good. This is about like my second or third time doing this, but this time I did it on straight hair, and when I actually did it on the mannequin head, I did it with the hair straight, so it was a really big experiment this time. But I do think that it came out pretty nice, guys, and I hope that it was an easy step to follow. I don't use a bleaching cap. I just kind of pull the pieces and just bleach as I go. One thing about it, you have to be kind of quick because if you're working on one side of the wig and you've already bleached that side, getting to the other side, you got to kind of be quick so that side doesn't process. So it is definitely a challenge, but I kind of worked fast around and I got it done. So this is the final look. Obviously, I showed you guys what it looked like straight in the beginning. I prefer it like this. I think this way looks super duper glam. I did go ahead and re-bleach the front and I did pull some hair off the front as well too, prior to showing you guys the wig. So it did come bleached, but like I said, I'm learning how to do bleach style. So I did go ahead and bleach the front of this one, and I feel like it looks flawless AF, and you guys can see how natural the transition is in the front. I think this one came out very, very nice. So this is going to be one of my springtime to summertime transitional wigs. I love the length. It's not too long. It's perfect and has a greater bounce and a greater bit of volume since it's cut short. So I will turn around and show you guys what the back looks like, but overall I think that this is fabulous. So guys, I will leave all the information down below if you're interested in purchasing this unit from doubleleafwig.com. Do not forget, guys, to thumbs up this video, leave your comments down below, subscribe, and share this video with your friends and family people. And I will catch you guys in a later one. Bye.